It's the Smite Pro League powered by Curse Voice. Gandhi joined by DM. How are you, my friend? I've seen you all day today.
I went to work today.
Yeah, you're a grown-up. He's also got his own shirt coming in hot. You're going to look good in it.
I don't know that that's accurate.
Yeah, I'm going to make sure it's accurate.
Speaking of which, you were telling me about the laptop you were trying to sell me.
What? Oh, I get it. Oh, you're so witty.
Cog and AFK coming up in just a second here.
That was good. That was a really good burn. Right. But yeah, so AFK versus Cognitive Gaming will be our next matchup here. AFK, very, very strong right now. Cognitive Gaming, though, it looks like they're kind of starting to trend up after last week.
I mean, but they have a really hard matchup here. I
yeah,
mean,
to say the least.
Last matchup wasn't super difficult compared to AFK, winners of the last LAN. We'll see what happens.
Yeah.
AFK has been known to troll their way through a few times, so we'll see if maybe that catches the better of them this time.
Fair point. Well, it's time for picks and bans. Ladies and gentlemen, we're hopping right into the action. Thursday night Smite coming in hot.
P's and B's.
Nope.
P's and B's.
Not doing it.
P's and B's.
Not doing it.
All right, we got even money right now, Gandhi, on who Cyclone is going to pick.
Okay. Cyclone, who is he going to pick? I'm feeling a Kronos before. I don't know why. I'm just going Kronos.
I'm going to say Master Yi.
Oh,
all right, so we got the bans coming out. Nothing surprising here. I really like the ban of Shivalanke from COG.
As they should.
Yeah, take the shot at Allied. You need to.
Well, Allied, it's funny. I asked him not too long ago. I go, Allied, what have you been playing recently in the scrims? He goes, oh, dude, I'm just designated Shivalanke, man. They just let me lock in, and then I just see him at 30 minutes.
Speaking of designated, Isis going to get taken away from Kiki. Very smart picking and banning phase coming out from COG so far. Really taking respect bans and respect picks away from AFK. Bellona going to get locked in. Could be for Weekend. Could be for Cyclone. But Geb probably going to be for Incon.
Yep, Geb will be going to Incon. Now, Bellona, we actually saw him be hot and cold last week. In game number one last week, he had like 8,000 player damage, and we were like, oh my god, Weekend, what's happening to you?
But it was a 40-minute game, too.
And it was a hard matchup for him, all things considered as well. I mean, you have a bunch of silences, but then the next game, Weekend just destroys everything.
Yep.
And that's how Bellona goes.
For me, I felt like he got a little bit cocky with his build. He was a little bit ahead in the beginning and then got a little strange with it. Second game, he played by the book, which Weekend does perfectly and destroyed. Bottom side, Apollo and Ares going to be locked in here. We could see with this Geb starting off with Mark of the Vanguard as a result, trying to make sure that he stays alive in lane for a little while longer with Medusa locked in for Allied.
Yep.
The character that just absolutely tore Eager to shreds.
Yeah, which is going to be interesting here so far. I mean, Ares will have a good presence at the mid harpies, but if Medusa can get that presence there as well, I mean, it's going to be very hard for Cognitive Gaming to contest him at all.
Well, that's exactly what Ally did in the last time we saw him play
this.
Didn't
he have Sylvanas, though?
I mean, it doesn't matter what he had. He hit level 5 and stunned one person and slowed two other with his ult at mid camps. They won the game from the 3-minute mark because of the way Ally played it. And if someone could rerun, you know, run it back, I would expect that Ally would be the man to do it. But back into the banning phase here, Hunbats, Bastet, gone.
Yep. Hunbats, who for whatever reason Weekend doesn't really tend to run just because, oh well, never mind. So that's going to be the Fenrir going to Cyclone spin.
Yeah, more than likely.
So I was a little bit off with Kronos, you know, close in the alphabet, maybe a little bit.
Well, they still might pick it. They need a mage.
They do need a mage. They do have no magical damage, which Cognitive Gaming definitely is going to be contemplating here.
They have Geb up there.
Okay.
They got Geb.
Yeah, they do.
They could build Mystical Male Soul Reaver Geb.
Okay, turn up.
They won't, but Hercules going to get locked in. An interesting matchup, Fenrir versus Hercules, and something that we actually saw at the Smite World Championship. Divios actually bringing out Fenrir as a counter to Hercules and doing very well with it. Omega just had a little bit better of an endgame.
Yep. Now, Cabrakan will be going to Bickham here into the jungle.
Yep.
As Hunbats gets taken out, grab Cabrakan. Very strong early on. Cabrakan excels when he's ahead. But from behind, he is one of the worst gods to possibly play in competitive play.
Well, I mean, he still brings a lot of CC to the table. The issue is, to be able to do that CC, he's got to be right up in their face. Sobek going to be locked in.
All right. Kiki can only play girls. Kiki, Medusa. Allied Bellona. I have no idea. Brandon, you're the analyst. I'm the guy who just says things.
It looks like Sobek has to go to the solo lane.
Okay,
right?
so then
Bellona or Medusa would be the smartest Fenrir actually has a pretty good matchup against Isis if her 3 and her 2 are down. I mean, it could be Geb.
No, it's definitely not Geb. We can rule out Geb.
It's definitely not Geb.
I mean, I guess Bellona could stick to Isis decently, but, like, Medusa doesn't have the clear to really... I mean, actually, I don't know, dude. It's really, it's gonna be hard.
Let's
but
not, oh my God, it's Kiki playing
no.
Fenrir in the mid lane.
No, he's not.
Now that is not a girl dog.
No, that is so that if, is as manly history, as it gets.
If history will tell us anything, it doesn't matter what who the god is that Kiki's playing. But if it's not female, he's gonna have a hard time. I know people think it's a joke. I know people think it's a funny stigma, but the stats actually prove the theory.
Spring Split, the funniest thing was, coming into the Spring Split, we were all like, oh, you know, Kiki, he's okay. He's okay, but
Isis is good.
88% win rate, their entire team with Isis. And we go, okay, so Kiki's got one god, and then he's got, like, Ra, maybe. But everyone has a Ra.
But then he came out with that Athena.
Oof, the Athena was brutal.
It was real, real brutal. Just great play.
But again, it's a female god.
Yeah, that's always the point. But AFK running a 4-hog meta here with Fenrir running it in the mid lane as well. 2 blue stones on the board, 1 for Hercules. And we're going to be getting into it. Nothing too crazy going on here. Are we going to see any 4 camp starts?
No.
I think Geb from the back line is just looking to get the rollout damage.
Yeah. Yeah. No, he's coming in and
get some rollout damage there. It's a little bit more damaging than some of the other moves. Usually safer just to go shockwave. But Kiki gonna start off with this red buff. I really want to follow him into lane here and see how he begins this. Now their clear was a little bit slower than the bottom side, despite the fact that Isis is getting into lane late. It is a 5-step differential. Jumps in, stuns it out. This could actually be first blood. Please, one more doesn't get it.
Well. That's the idea there, is hand the front, go ahead and go and aggress.
Well, that's actually Jerby's meta. He used to have a pub stompy kind of ranked start where he would go into lane with Hog, get level 2 immediately off the red, and kill somebody.
Yeah.
He did it all the time. It was like the best ranked strategy. Bickham rotating very quickly. Kiki's got to be much more careful now. There's a lot of CC on the side of Cog. Won't be able to go in safely.
Yeah, Hercules didn't get any of the 2v2 action because Bickham was forced to rotate immediately to really just try to bail out the Isis in case Kiki did go forward. But DM, give me a little bit about how this matchup's going to work. Isis so strong early on, and now since Hand of the Gods will be down for another 43 seconds, she's going to have the superior wave clear. So what can Fenrir do?
Fenrir is looking for 2 main things. 1, he needs to bait out the Spirit Ball before going in. Like that without tanking the damage.
Yeah, it's good to have it just hit you right in the face, though, too.
And then second, he can't actually utilize the Brutalize unless the Silence is down. Actually better than the Spirit Ball for stopping it. Comes out a little bit faster. Nice stun. He's going to walk away from that one. Brutalize used as a short hop. Bludgeon going to hit 2.
Woo!
Big shot, but Kiki, no follow-up. Heroin getting locked down and going to head to the back line.
That's very hard to get off the full bludgeon, especially when you're talking about going up against an Isis and a Cabrakan who have 2 interrupts.
They have 4 interrupts.
they have the
ways to stop that. And neither of them decided that it would have been a good idea, cooldowns notwithstanding.
Yeah, so Apollo and Ares, A-squared, going into the duo lane here, facing off against the Medusa and Geb. Apollo's starting to see a lot more favor so far in the midsummer split.
Well, you know, Cyclone was actually the person to talk about this with me, and he said, like, listen, you start off Death Toll, which we did see Famous Hate do. You go into Morningstar, level 2, you're swinging for 70 damage. Couple that with the Audacity, 100% increase in attack speed, and you are gonna hit.
Yeah. And Audacity's no joke either. Now, Medusa pretty much has Audacity on her 1.
Well, it used to be at least.
Oh, yeah, it used to be.
Level 1 now, which is where you're going to see it sit for a while, is actually only 40% if memory serves, as opposed to the 100 where it first launched. Cyclone Spin is Sobek getting pushed under the tower there. A little bit surprising to me, not to see Cyclone losing in the early game. Moreover, just to see Cyclone playing a Guardian. This is not something that I think we're very attuned to.
Wow. So both mid-harpies will go cleanly to AFK. Fenrir, a.k.a. Kiki, will go ahead and jump over, clear the right side. Weaken was able to
hogs.
Get the last. Yeah.
They better get him.
That's a good point. And how long will it be until Fenrir just decides to opt in? He needs to get hand 2 as well. he wants the 60-second cooldown.
It would have been... Yeah, I'm very surprised to see him not start with it. One of the reasons that you get more pots in solo and dual lane than you do in mid is because the walk back to mid lane is actually much shorter.
Yeah.
So you don't need as much... Oh, nice. Ooh. Pulls him right out of it. Meerkat looking for damage here. Cyclone's been getting very low in terms of mana. Forgot, I guess, to use his ultimate for mana regeneration. Going to be pushed away here.
Now, he started off with Mark of the Vanguard instead of seeing that mystical mail kind of rush where we pretty much see every time out of Sobek's in solo lane.
It allows him to be a little bit more tanky in terms of tanking creep damage as opposed to just getting physical protection. So it will help him a little bit more than it would have otherwise. The big trick here is though what he goes into next, and he's actually going to choose boots.
Hmm.
Wow.
And now Homie FA actually going with the Watcher's Gift here instead of the Mark of the Vanguard. Now, traditionally, Ares players like to be so aggressive in lane, but maybe it's just a respect of Incon where he realized, well, if I get out of position, he's probably going to make me pay.
Well, to the same point, Incon didn't build Mark of the Vanguard himself, goes into Watcher's Gift, which again might be a lack of respect to the Ares. Ares is 100% channeled and dot damage. That's what he does. He's just drilling into you with auto attacks, right, while the chains and the flames are going off. And Mark of the Vanguard probably serves defense against Ares better than any other character in the game, and still, Incon's like, I just want the extra gold. I'm not worried about his first blood opportunities.
Yeah. Well, no mid harpies and for another 2 minutes here, as we will see. Apollo, he's got a little bit of an advantage in the lane here. He's got a couple more stacks on Heartseeker, but that's really about it, so that gives him like 100 extra gold. But Apollo with the Heartseeker is a good buff in damage, but so is Medusa with one.
Late game, you're probably going to see Apollo be a little bit stronger than Medusa. This is where Medusa's really going to shine. Level 6 to level 13, she'll be able to outclass Apollo front to back because he is relying a lot on Audacity at this stage of the game, which he's not always going to have active. All of Allied's damage is activatable through his 1, his 2, his 3, and of course the amazing ultimate with probably some of the best teamfight potentials that Hunters might have. Fighting early Gold Furies, especially when they have a Geb who is so hard to pull off the Gold Fury himself, would be such a great play. So I expect that we're going to see Cognitive make plays for that early on. But with the Fenrir, things might get a little bit strange.
I'm not sure how that's going to shake up. And Heroine, we're so used to seeing Isis just dominate this mid lane in all the matches just because of Wind Gust is such a superior clear to almost every other ability early on. She can't really control the lane like that.
So, you know, talking back to the Gold Fury push, I'm really... Oh, wait. We're going to look at Home AFA. Woo! Just getting jumped on from all sides here. Goes down, and no escape is on cooldown. Weaken taking a lot of damage here. Explosion not going to be good. He's not blocked off. There comes Apollo off the mark. That's the last of his mana there. He's disarmed.
No way.
Weaken should be healing.
Oh!
Sun, turn around! Adamana, Allies looking for another kill here, but it's Adamana himself. Bickham going to be picked off. First two kills going to AFK.
Well, and just like that, Meerkat actually hits the rotation. Boulder comes out, actually hits the Incon on the backside. And now Hercules still trying to chase down.
What was that?
Incon ran right
Did
into it.
Did he forget?
Dude. Yeah, that's like when I first started playing. Like every time Kukulkan throws down his tornadoes, I just walk right into him.
Incon giving up a rather haphazard death there. Meerkat putting
Could
himself
trouble.
In trouble. Wow, huge bludgeon.
That's
a kill.
Done. Homie FA might be in trouble.
No.
They're not going to hit the pluck.
Well, the pluck was on cooldown. Tail Whip actually didn't affect. Remember that the flames going to keep him knockback immune, which is very important. So he uses them as an escape mechanic, a high-level Ares display right there from Homie FA.
So now already we're starting to see AFK. They get a little bit of a swing here. They weren't able to take too much out of it, but the scoreboard does read 3-1 in favor of AFK. Gold difference, 1,100.
Famous Hate right there decided to tank creeps up. Now that might have been maybe a pattern or something that he's used to doing, but it's definitely something he shouldn't have done. Letting a little bit of gold into the tower there as opposed to losing a couple hundred health could really help him, because if Ally takes control of this lane again, it's going to be very hard for him to deal with.
Yeah, well, he's actually losing this lane so far.
Well,
Allied was unable to get that kill, so I think Apollo kind of knows that. He's like, well, you know, Allied didn't get a kill there. I'm pretty much in parity with him. I think I can take a couple.
Well, he does, and he might be in a little bit of trouble, which Homie FA recognizes. They're going to turn to Heroine. Bead's going to be used there. Heroine gets out of the double ult. Kiki really not playing to the strength there as he uses a CC-enabled ultimate on top of a CC-enabled ultimate. Incon actually forcing the beads right away.
Weaken's lingering on the right around the side. He does have Eagle's Rally as well, so He was standing on a ward, so he probably won't get this gank, as Bickham will be here. Now, the real question here is Bickham. He's down one level right now to Weaken, who is rushing in Ikavo, it looks like, almost immediately here, right after Boots. And we talked about it a little bit before. Cabrakan, he's going to be very hard to play if he gets behind.
Right, but I mean, so far, I mean, he's level 9. He's not too far
behind.
Yeah,
he's not far behind right
now. He does have a death, but the 500 gold difference might start playing soon. It's going to be up to Weaken and Incon to really begin those rotations, because the rotations right now are the big strength of Cognitive. They have better movement speed. They have better control in team fights, barring Isis, of course. Yeah. But the big thing is, the longer they stop Cabrakan from farming and forcing him into fights he doesn't want to be in, the better they're going to be in the mid game.
Hand 3 online here for Weaken, super early, as well as Incon. So both of them have Hand of the Gods available to them. So that tells us one thing. They are looking for the objective as quick as they possibly can here. Two hand threes at 9 minutes. You got to kind of try to screw that one up.
I mean, they should really just be rushing this down. The only difference is that Ares does have hand 3 as well. But I mean, considering that fact, it shouldn't be too difficult for them to shut him down ASAP. He's level 8 right now. Doesn't have a lot of defense online. In fact, doesn't really have any at all. Yeah. And Ares is not really known as a super mobile character. He doesn't have 3 chains on and the bolster defense is going. He's generally pretty easy to pick off at this stage of the game.
He also doesn't have a Geb shield. Driving strike right into the face of Weaken, as they will just try to cut away at Meerkat, who was looking for the knockup just off the mark.
Look at this. Bickham rotates over to solo. Really puts himself in an awkward spot. Almost gave up control here. He's going to have to use Hand of the Gods. Weaken's coming in.
It might get stolen, and Weaken just walks straight in and takes it. Now the silence comes out on Kiki.
Jump should still be up here.
Yeah.
That looked like
he's got the chain on him. Eagle's Rally comes in. Bludgeon's looking to follow up. Apollo comes crashing down. Homie FA will try to get someone, but unable to do so. Cyclone Spin picks up one. Wing Gust will grab another, as now Cyclone Spin just going to try to stay alive here as Ally dodges it. Acid Spray coming down. And, well, Cognitive Gaming at least stop it a little bit. Kind of.
Two to five right now, it's a little bit awkward. And right there, Allied at full health, just shutting them down completely. Picks up a Sentry Ward as well, putting himself in a really good spot for Gold Fury pressure once again. And remember, with two hand threes on the line, it's going to be very hard for them to fight that control.
How odd is it to see that Allied's rotations, like in Spring Split during online portion, let me say that, Allied just seemed to be 10 seconds late to a fight. It felt like 10 seconds when you watch it. How many times did we see Ally just be the last one alive on his team and at like Fire Giant? Now he's rotating with an Apollo.
It's a very different AFK this split. Much more coordinated, it seems. I think people are starting to recognize the we're going to feed Cyclone strategy, and they're not letting it run down anymore, which might be one of the reasons that we're seeing him on Sobek. Not a god we normally see him on. Usually he likes assassins, very mobile gods. This time, looking for major frontline. And so far, it's working out. He's 3-0-1. He's got his first 2 items online, and Breastplate of Valor is going to help him out a lot.
Well, AFK really doesn't want this game to go past 30 minutes.
I would say so. I mean, that's a very early game team. I mean, even the Medusa is an early game hunter compared to Apollo.
Yeah, she shines from like 15 to 25 minutes, right? Like, that's when she's just killing everything. Her ultimate's perfect in teamfights, but
look at this.
Cognitive has started up the Gold Fury here. Famous Hate's going to be taking it up. He's got the Aussie, and they're going to be able to get this. Yeah.
Wow.
So the team with 4 Hand of the Gods.
Incon just completely out of position. Yes, you did see Meerkat push him out, but when it really came down to it, it was 100% due to the fact that Incon didn't start his rotation in sooner. Off the mark on the boulder. Driving Strike will hit a few, but he gives up his life there haphazardly and gives back some of the gold that they really just earned for free. And then over in the right side, you can see these creeps pushing down this tower, now sitting at about 10% health.
The question is what AFK will take for this.
There it
is. Blink Cataclysm comes in as well. Eagle's Rally follows it up. The bludgeon was great. Kiki gets himself a kill. They're not done, though, as Bickham will throw down. And now Apollo comes crashing in. Allied will hit the rotation as well. He'll be a little bit late, but Cyclone's been baiting perfectly. Weaken again gets a full bludgeon off. And now Medusa ult comes in. Kiki looking for it. Brutalize on him. The 2 chains on him. Cyclone Spin gets himself another kill.
And with that tower, about to take some pretty serious damage here. You can see them rushing right in. Tier 1 definitely going to fall here. Cyclone begins his rotation back over towards the other side, albeit a bit low in the health department. He does have way to sustain himself, and I think that's what he's going to do. Sickening Strike on the creeps, another tier one should fall in right, and all the gold from the original Gold Fury push is most likely going to be completely stripped away here. Let's take a look at the graphs as the second tower, stays alive.
Yep. Second tower, I mean, it's up for the time being, but one wave and it's done, right? I mean, it's not going to be up for long, but you can see this spike in gold, which is right where the Gold Fury happened, and now we're seeing 1,500 gold lead here in favor of AFK, but the big story, again, is experience. I mean, there's so much experience given for a god kill, and that's really what AFK is riding on right now.
Yeah, Bickham a level behind, Meerkat two levels, Herwind a level, Incon has a level up, and then Allied has a level up. Every single person right now on AFK has more gold and experience than their opponent, which is pretty much what you want to see at this stage of the game if you're looking for a quick win. The only person who's even close to in line at this point is Meerkat, but with the two deaths, he's also given some of that gold back, so it's going to be very hard for him to come back into this game as Hercules. I mean, especially with this build, I mean, you take a look, the boots were started very early. He's going into Jotun's directly after. Kiki, though, in a lot of trouble, forced to use Ragnarok to try to get away and should be safe, but wasting the ultimate.
Now, we got to touch on Kiki's build here. He doesn't have any damage at all.
Yeah, boots.
Oh, okay. Well, you got the power from boots, okay? And then you have Heartward Amulet, well, and then he's going into Magi's Blessing.
There's three ways to build Fenrir. First of all, you have your auto attack builds. Utilizing Seething Howl has two to increase your damage and lifesteal. You build major attack speed, a little bit of frontline defense, and you make sure that you can stay alive forever while dealing massive amounts of damage.
All right.
You could build him your normal assassin route, talking about cooldown reduction, things like Jotun's Wrath, Wing Blades, Spirit Robes, anything to get him to max CDR, so that way he can repeatedly unchain and brutalize over and over and over. Or finally, the third and usually the most fan favorite is going to be your tank frontline Fenrir, and that's in this case what he's looking for. You build a little bit of damage in the early game to augment your brutalized damage, which is one of the hardest hitting abilities at level 9, which tends to fall off. You transition from that assassin role into a complete frontliner in the end game, absorbing damage, giving it away, but right now, speaking of giving away, Famous Hate almost threw his life away there, getting very greedy in the jungle.
The moves coming out as we will go ahead and watch. We can clear this one up.
Well, try to. I mean, those wind gusts coming through, keeping him at bay.
Kiki's here. They might try to aggress on Bickham, and just going to be off as now Bickham will be forced out. He didn't have his passive up, or else it would have resulted in a stun, as we will see as Herwin will go back to the base and buy up. He's going to go full-blown Warlock Sash here, so it's really going to be about a 10-minute commitment coming out of Cognitive Gaming here by picking up that item. It's going to be very hard to get those stacks, especially in the mid lane with how this game's going. I mean, your tier 1's down. AFK is really trying to aggress. It's going to be hard for Herwin to get 100 stacks, and this is an item you need stacks on.
Looking at the levels here again, Homie FA level 11 right now, facing down a level 15 Medusa, although he does have a level 15 on his side as well. We're looking at Kiki jumping in, getting silenced out. The Brutalize was actually used there, but Herwin recognizes the fact that he could only really escape in one direction, baits out the jump, and takes some damage with him. Nice play.
Well, Incon rolls directly into a Hercules. Meerkat throws Cyclone Spin back. Cyclone Spin says, hey, I got a pluck too. In comes Kiki. He's looking for it, and he's actually going to peel off of him. He doesn't want to go for this fight as Cyclone forced to lurk in the waters, and Apollo comes crashing in. Fenrir forced to jump. No escape's going to be activated. Ragnarok will follow up. The boulder did so much. This is a perfect fight for Cognitive Gaming as long as they can get it. But Allied, he's on the backside. He's trying to take down Homie FA. He needs to hit a couple more autos as Incon picks up one. Allied's got one. Meerkat will be able to clean him up. Down goes the Crocodile of the Nile. But now we will see as Weekend will join the party, and they're going to look to clean this one up, DM.
Yeah, they should have Meerkat here with no problem. Bead's going to be used there. Obviously not going to be enough. He doesn't have the reset. Weekend shouldn't have too much more trouble, even with a driving strike here. Bickham actually winds up picking up Kiki. Where was Incon in that engagement? Weekend running out of time here. Driving strike going to be used, but a perfect shield right
that
after
was amazing
to take him out of the CC. That was lightning fast. Kill finally happens. Winds up being a 3-4 overall.
They gotta be very careful as Apollo is just gonna go ahead and straight in.
Was that a 3-2?
Maybe?
3-3. Even exchange. Actually, probably a positive exchange for Cognitive. When it comes down to that one, Incon, way too far did he chase for the kill at the bottom side of the map with
Allied was left alone in mid-harpies in the middle of three people.
When you're a support, your number one role is to save the carries. Instead, he was chasing a kill with Kiki, maybe even trying to save Kiki, but his focus should have been Medusa.
Gold Fury's up. They're starting it up. Incon looking for
can't
it.
Blink.
He can't blink. He's in combat. Magi's popped as well. Allied's coming in hot. He's looking for the damage, and he will lacerate away as Incon will now try to just get
he's
his blink off.
Ult.
It's not happening.
They gotta face
and he's
going
to walk straight in. And
wow.
Now Cataclysm follows up. Incon was not able to secure it as Cognitive will take the Gold Fury. Hurlwind now. He's going to be slowed by lurking in the waters. This is done for him as Ragnarok will bring Bickham back to him. And now this is Cabrakan. He's super tanky, but he's also super dead.
That right there is what I wanted to see from Incon. He gave up the push right there because of a great ult from Bickham, but when it came down to it, he chose the right targets to save. He was CCing where he needed to, and it was a much better fight for them overall. Meerkat, maybe even foolishly, running into too many people here, saves the red, but has he given himself away? Cyclone is looking to chase this down. Doesn't look like anyone else was.
No one can kill this Hercules.
You're going a fire giant. His goal isn't to kill Hercules. His goal is to keep him away from FG. But I think that Meerkat has sniffed this out. Even if he has, though, looking at the build, does he have hand three? No, he has hand one.
Incon's got hand three.
Even if he gets in there, I mean, I don't know what he's doing.
I don't know how I feel about Cyclone Spin rocking out on a support. I just feel like he's so impactful. Oh my god, Meerkat just walked into a 1v5 and somehow did perfect in this. No escape comes out. Apollo comes crashing down. Fire Giant has been secured by Cognitive Gaming. They steal it.
I don't know what happened there.
Meerkat came in, flexed his biceps, kissed him a couple times, and threw a boulder.
I mean, but the hand of the god steal, like Incon put himself in a bad spot. He was tanking way too much damage from the fire giant, standing in lava, I think, for 3 ticks. If I did see it from correctly, the camera was a little bit far behind. I didn't quite get to see how much damage he took. I was kind of looking at the sidebars themselves. But it looks like he just took too much damage from tanking up the FG itself.
You know, it's funny. I just made that comment on Cyclone Spin with supports, and I was getting ready to follow it up with, well, you know, he's not really putting out the same impact, but he's 5 kills already. Ragnarok has equipped Homie FA right into the tower, and Ares will fall here. Incon hits the Cataclysm as well. He's now going to be forced to body block as Famous Hate dodges the lacerate. And
now
Eagles rally to just crown it all out. AFK, they say, okay, you guys got the fire giant, that's cool. We're still gonna just punish you. Kiki gets
so
silenced
much
out though, yeah.
So much damage into Kiki here. He should have recognized the Geb. The silence would have been more than enough, but he overcommits. He's gonna drop. The fire giant's gonna go down for him as well. Meerkat still way far behind in this fight. Again, gonna throw himself into the mercy of 4 to 5 people here. Cyclone begins a rotation, but we'll take the scenic route as he stops at the mid-cast.
It's funny how tanky Hercules is already in this game, and he's just got a Runeforge and a Jotuns, right? Like, you would think in that one engagement at mid-harp, you'd be like, okay, he's got Mystical Mail, he's got Midgardian Mail. But no, it's just Mitigate Wounds, man. So strong.
Looking at Sobek here, we're going to see an Ethereal Staff picked up off his last back. Expect a little bit more health to come out as well. In that fifth slot, maybe even possibly the sixth. Soul Reaver is something we want to see, and he did pick up a Weakening Curse as well to try to shut down the healing.
Beads forced out here from Meerkat. Not an active we always see on Hercules, but with this team comp, definitely makes sense.
See, I mean, I like Beads on Hercules. I think
it's
smart.
You liked Meditation.
Not in Season 2.
Rip.
Speaking of which, you can buy a shirt if you'd like. It's all about it. You all right?
Yeah, man. I was just thinking about how cool I would look in the in a juice shirt.
Production's mad.
He
gave me the opening, guys. What are you going to do? Cog right now, still pretty far behind, even with their 2 Gold Furies. Now, it doesn't look like in gold, but the experience is telling a different story as they fall 10,000 to the hole. And with nobody being level 20, you're looking at the big disparities here. Incon being 2 levels up, Kiki being 2 levels up.
Weakened.
But the story is, yeah, weakened.
Four.
Four then levels
this
ahead.
This is what we were talking about with Cabrakan. He's very, very hard to get going. And another thing I want to touch on here. At 16 minutes, Hurlwind finished this Warlock Sash, and I said it's going to be about a 10-minute commitment. He's only got 20 stacks because
fighting.
Of all the fighting.
Fighting.
This is a very ballsy item to build at 16 minutes if you lose your Tier 1 tower.
Now, I'm looking at Weaken here. The last time we saw him play Bellona was against Eager. Second item, a second item, Nemean Lion, wound up doing 0 damage throughout the game. This time, very standard Bellona build. Ninja Tabby for the attack speed, Iqbal for the attack speed and damage reduction, and then Frostbound Hammer for the attack speed slow on top of the fact that he's gaining movement speed slows and extra damage and health. This is the standard Warrior Bellona build that you're going to see most of the time, and he's destroying with it. In fact, let's take a look at damage done here as our next fight's about to start.
Leading the way will be allied with 15,000.
Why is Cyclone Sobek in second place?
I don't. Who knows, man?
What?
Dude, who knows?
How?
I don't get it.
He doesn't have mystical mail.
Well, Allied's the quiet assassin. He's 6-1-7 out of... He's been in like one fight, right?
Speaking of fighting here, Meerkat trying to work his way in as Allied continues to tank it up. Bickham, homie FA, trying to find a way past for the blink, but we can get to shut that down. Getting a little closer, and they're going to pick that up.
Eagles rally force out defensively. Cyclone's been just really going to try to zone him out. Ragnarok comes out. Boulder's good. The stone's a little bit better, though. Homie FA could be in a lot of trouble. Beads already forced out for Meerkat. Kiki jumps back in. Preemptive Beads now, but he has to go right through Cabrak, and he's so very low. Famous Hate just needs to hit one auto, and he does.
No way he's getting out of that one. He's going up. He's going to be looking for another one. Cyclone.
This is the play.
Very low here. He
Curtains.
Got him. Two kills. Double. For Famous.
That's big. Get it on that Hunter. Get him all of the kills.
I have no idea whose idea it was to reinitiate in that fight, but it was absolutely the wrong call. They spent so much time trying to keep them out and so many of their cooldowns as not an aggressively defensive measure.
Yeah.
Speaking of like weakened, diving to the front, taking a lot of damage just to make sure they can't blink in, steal it away. They get the gold fury.
That was one of the weirdest parts of the engagement to really... Attest to your point is the fact that Weaken used Eagles Rally defensively.
Get the speed buff.
Nope. Wards.
Again, you know, that's the pain of spectators. He doesn't know they're not doing that. He doesn't know that they're not doing the Fire Giant yet. He couldn't just stop there. That was a very smart play. From a spectator standpoint, it was super frustrating.
Yeah.
Because we know that they're not doing that. It's when the killer's after someone in a movie and they don't know it, like, don't turn around. Oh, my God. We can just do the speed buff.
To be fair, a lot of people act pretty stupid in scary movies.
I feel like
I'm going to put myself in the top room in the bottom corner to make sure I can't get out. Weaken, half health, cognitive, looking to chase him down here. Is Hurwin will go.
As if Bickham used that ult right there where he should have to lock Weaken in and force the ult, he would have described what you were describing about the scary movie. That would have been great. But no, Fire Giant remains healthy for now. They turn their sights to the speed buff on the bottom side. Hurwin, huge help there with the Wind Gust.
The knockup coming up here. Incon now going to try to zone him out, but Meerkat, he's fearless at this point. He's very, very strong.
He's got to use his frontline potential. That's one thing. Every time that we've seen the fight go well, it's because Meerkat's been there earlier with Hercules.
That's a very good point.
They need to utilize the Hercules. The problem is that every time they lose a fight, it's because Meerkat hasn't rotated there yet. They lost the Tier 2 fight on right because they couldn't dive hard enough. They lost the fight earlier on because Meerkat's rotation was 60 minutes behind Cyclones. He's got to be at the front of the fight. He's the tankiest person on the team by a mile.
To be fair, though, it's hard to rotate with Cyclones, Ben, who we all kind of regard as the best solo laner in the world.
If not the best player.
Yeah. He's definitely in the top category for, well, just about every god and any position you want to put him against. He's just so technically sound, but at damn near 27 minutes here, it's 19-9, and Fire Giant is up, Gold Fury's up, or Gold Fury will be up in about 2 minutes, but it's all about the Fire Giant at this point. Sure, they'll grab the buffs because they're very important at this state of the game, but this Fire Giant will make or break it for one team.
So usually I'm a huge fan of Voidstone. It's an item that I think does not get nearly enough playtime. Same thing for Void Shield when you have heavy physicals. But Cyclone, strangely to me, is building a Voidstone in a place where it's not really going to be utilized all that well. The only magic damage on this team is him and a Geb who has literally built 0 points of damage.
As he should.
I'm sorry, Traveler Shoes has like 20 magic power on it, whatever it is.
It's still, at this point in the game, it's zero, right? I mean, it's pretty much gone. Yeah,
right.
It's Gap.
It's really not going to affect his damage all that much. If he was looking for extra damage and defense, I'm surprised he just didn't get something like Gem of Isolation.
Well, Weaken might have taken a bad route here. There might pinch him. Nope. And he's just trying to push his wave and try to get it up to the tier 2 so they can have a little bit of extra vision and just kind of keep that pressure on cognitive. But it's just a dance.
You know, and this is what I talked about. I ran a big casting discussion on my stream the other day.
Okay.
And, you know, one of the things I talked about is the major importance of what we call footsies in the fighting game community. And this is the fighting, or the MOBA equivalent of footsies. It's the ability to bait your opponent to overcommitting to a situation in which you think you have the advantage. It is 100% a bait. And in this case, what they're looking to do is put, it's all Kiki. They're looking to pull Kiki out of position, bait him into using an Unchained that he can't really confirm off of. Put him in a situation where he's going to take 60 to 70% of his health, which will bait Incon into the fight as well. Bait Cyclone into the fight as well. They're looking to get Kiki in there, waste the Eagles rally, throw out the buffs, and then reinitiate. If they can get those things off safely, Kog can take the team fight. But at the same time, remember, the advantage still belongs to AFK, albeit it's getting a little bit smaller thanks to the level 20s coming online, but they've got to use their front line more efficiently. Can they find a way to bait Kiki, or can they find an initiation where someone like Allied's going to be out of position?
The other big thing here is that Cognitive Gaming has to deal with breaking Magi's on so many different players, and Incon still has his Magi, so does Weaken. And now it looks like the tables have finally turned, the Magi's have been popped. Fenrir comes in. He's got one. Apollo comes crashing down. He turns one into stone, forces out the bead. Sprint 3 activated. Allied gets taken out there by the shoulder of Hercules, but he's going to get saved by Cyclone. And now they will all turn on the Meerkat, chase him down, and soon he will fall. Beads forced out again, and Homie FA trying to slow this one down, but is it going to be enough? The pluck was going
to
be good.
See, they don't have to kill Meerkat. That's the thing, is Meerkat's baiting his team here because Homie FA is a super squishy target at this stage of the game. Incon, strangely, out of position here as Kiki rotates over. Stone Shield already down.
Meerkat's not worried about it. He's looking at four members of AFK trying to go toe-to-toe, and Kiki says, no, you don't.
He should have been worried about it. Bickham trying to find the stun here. Doesn't get it. Tremor's not going to be enough. Tail whip looking for it.
Bangarang.
Sickening strike puts him in the box.
Directly to the fire giant is where AFK Gaming will be going. There is one member alive. It's Homie FA.
Look at this. Cyclone Spin not only stealing the buff, but playing the defense they need, making sure that he can't blink. And with that, fire giant will be free this time for AFK. Cognitive going to be in some deep trouble. And, you know, we go back to the footsies discussion. They didn't play to their advantage. They waited too long for Kiki to be put out of position. They didn't use their frontliners effectively. They gave up space control by throwing themselves away from the fire giant pit and onto their side of the jungle, which gave Incon very intelligently more than enough time to start up a rollout, make himself CC immune, get to the back line. At that point, we already saw the Tail Whip take the Magi's off of Hercules. This is the problem. The build was going so well until the Magi's Blessing.
Yeah.
But if you're going to build Beads and Magi's on a character, on a character who's already almost invincible, what's the point?
Yeah. Well, and I think I really chalked that last one, that the footsies that you're talking about of Cognitive Gaming, I think the problem there was trying to find a way to pop the Magi's. I mean, well, you got Isis, you're going to have, Cabrakan can do it, but he's got to put himself in a bad spot. They don't have that guaranteed Magi's knockup like they have with Geb on the side of AFK. And he just walks up, pounds the ground, and, oh, okay, four Magi's Blessings, they're popped.
Oh.
Now let's go in, boys.
Four crits in a row, Allied sends into the Cold Fury to start that fight off. Check out the damage here.
Dude,
he's already got that Rage online. Still has the Bluestone as well. Can we check Gold in Hand, please, as the Fire Giant goes down? Gold in Hand, Allied's looking at 720 or 730 right now with the sale of his item. He's looking at a little under 1300, so needs about 350 gold right now to finish the Deathbringer.
I don't know if we're gonna see another back here DM unless Cognitive Gaming can really hold, and it's gonna be tough. They're looking at a level 15 Ares, level 17 Cabrakan across the way, pretty much all level 20s with the exception of Incon, who's level 18. Kiki now taking a lot of damage here. He's forced to Ragnarok out defensively. Driving Strike will hit Weaken. And now they will bring out one person, which will be Cabrakan. The Spirit Ball is on the mark.
Allied.
The Boulder's even better. Meerkat gets one. They're going to be able to turn the tides here. And now, Famous Hate, he's going to be able to take out the Crocodile here. Cyclone Spin, down he goes. And the Fire Giant Curse, is that a thing?
I'm possible. Check out Famous Hate here. He's going to take to the sky.
No
will
way.
He spot them? Yeah.
No way.
Over a ward here. He's going right into Kiki. He needs the Mez here more than anything else, but they're guaranteed a Phoenix at this point. There's no way that that damage team can hold them off. Without Allied or Cyclone, there's no way they have enough damage to hold this off of a Phoenix right now.
How did that happen? What just happened?
It comes down to the Fenrir pick. I mean, it's not just that he's not playing a female, right? It comes down to the fact that Fenrir doesn't have the...
Oh, that's a big bludgeon. He's taking out Ares. He's got the disarm as well. He's got Geb Shield following him up, and they're going to try to turn this. Fenrir turns, grabs the Cabrakan. Bickham in a lot of trouble here. Down he goes. Meerkat on the backside. A little bit late, but the Spirit Ball will slow it up. Not enough, as Kiki will come directly back in. And
okay, so I need to fix my face here a little bit, because I said there was no way they wouldn't get a Phoenix. I will make an addendum to that clause, unless Meerkat, the only person on their team that can be in the front line, decides not to push with them.
Yeah.
Then it changes completely. I have no idea why he wasn't with them. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. I don't know if he was respawning, but the boulders seemed to do a lot there. For me, that came down. It looks like he came from the right side of the jungle. It looks like he was split pushing when he didn't need to be. And Hercules, of all people, should not be the split push.
And that boulder at the beginning really saved him. I mean, boulder with Cabrakan ultimate is also really good, just because you're like, oh, they're trapped.
Pinball.
I have to throw it at one spot.
Right, exactly. You don't have to think about it. It just will run two people, three people over multiple times. They did a lot of damage there. Plus, they used Herwin's ultimate perfectly there by placing it down and doing all the damage inside of it. Herwin, very smart not to explode it as Bickham was getting taken out of it either for the early damage. They used it as well as they could, and that was their successful defense. They shrink the gold lead a little bit, and given the fact that they're farming extraordinarily well, the lead is starting to get shrunk from an experience point as well. Bickham still behind, Kiki slightly ahead as well.
It's a big pick. If they can take out Isis, this is going to be really, really big for them.
He's CC immune. There's no stopping him.
And Incon, he's looking for a Cataclysm hits. Beads. Perfect there, as Weaken still does have his Magi's Blessing, and it did not get broken. And, that's going to do it. A Driving Strike will definitely pop a Magi's.
Well, with that, Allied should have backed and got his Deathbringer?
No.
No?
It he looks might like be going he, back soonish?
Did he opt to finish his actives instead? Because he had the goal for it. That's a guarantee.
Oh. Preemptive beads coming out from Weaken. He's got two chains on him. Searing Flesh canceled out. Now they're going to go ahead and secure this speed buff here. Fire Giant in 15 seconds. And that is going to be members of AFK retreating back to the base there. It's just Weaken.
Yeah, not member. It's just member.
Yeah, just member. He's 3-0-16. He's got a perfect game so far. He's been in almost every team fight possible.
I love that build, too.
Yeah,
look at this build.
It's beautiful.
And, you know, where on Hercules, it's not great, because Hercules will use teleport a lot better, especially from a solo lane perspective, than Bellona will from the jungle. She has not only the beads, but the Magi's, which does very well for her in this regard. She has high, maybe not great CDR reduction, but, of course, getting some with Spirit Robe, a great amount of attack speed.
Yeah.
Not to mention a ludicrous amount of health.
Yeah. That's just Frostbound Hammer.
Yeah, well. Eh.
Best item?
It's definitely
top five?
There. I would wager at least.
Okay. Cyclone Spin gets forced out here. Kiki now baited into the narrow corridor. Homie FA trying to bring him in.
Weaken
counter
in, no
initiates
problem.
It. And now Meerkat misses the Driving Strike. And the Petrify just off the mark. Bickham all by himself. The boulder's going to do so much. It even hits him on the backside there. And now Meerkat, he's swinging for the fences here, but it's not enough as Allied picks up one. He's looking for another one. Kiki gets another one. Geb Shield too strong.
Nobody died?
Well, five members of COG get died.
Oh, my. Dude, that was the dream. They had five people in a choke point with Nemesis ult down, with an Isis and a Hercules, and then they capped off the choke point with a Cabrakan ult. It was the dream. It literally could not have wound up any better for them, and somehow AFK still comes out on top through proper CC chaining, proper damage trading, and of course a great amount of support coming out not only from Incon, but Cyclone Spin as well.
Whew. AFK's got so much versatility these days. What did you think? So I'm going to get your first initial opinion. What did you think of the Fenrir throughout the entire game? Would you say it's something that we might see?
I don't think there's a reason to run it back. I think they tested it, and for it to not do as well as you would expect an assassin to run down a mage in the early game, especially on Kiki, who is known for his solo lane play before and his jungle, so he knows the Fenrir, and this is on a team that's seated way below them.
Yeah.
I can't imagine that they're going to play this god in that role against a higher-seeded team like Cloud9.
Well, time to take a look at First Blood here. This one was over in, 36 minutes, so it's been a while. Let's check in with the replay and see just how this game shook up, but In right, 1 second, we will.
We're going to do finger puppets. Oh, no, no, we're in there.
Oh, beautiful blink cataclysm coming in from Incon, who, you know, all things considered, normally when we cast an AFK match, it's Incon was in the perfect spot at the perfect time, and he did the thing. This time, it seemed like he was starting to chase a little bit and start getting peeled away.
Human.
Yeah.
He looked human for once. He was chasing a lot of kills that he didn't really even deserve. He was with Kiki. That was way too far out of position instead of saving Allied. One of the fights that they lost majorly was one of the fights they should have won in spades because Incon was out of position.
Yep. Well, let's see what the map tells us here as we will see the percentages. AFK 63%. That's 100% mid harpies.
Are you serious?
100.
Has that ever happened?
It's in like a 10 with an extra zero on the end.
Has that ever happened?
No. I just shot out of the dark there. It has.
Did it? Oh, say production.
It's happened once, but that's coming from Brad though. You gotta take that with a grain of salt.
I don't know, man. I don't think I've ever seen 100% mid harpies before. Wow.
That
wow,
is
AFK. Jeepers.
That was nuts. And you know what the funny thing was is that Cognitive Gaming was able to get that first Gold Fury. I it might have even been the first two.
Gandhi.
Shocker.
Even money here. Player of the game.
Cyclone.
Cyclone spin. Let's see. Show me Cyclone spin.
You could have went allied either. 8-4-13 here.
On
Cyclone spin. I just.
He had a 2-1 KD with 13 assists that game as Sobek.
Do you like his Guardian play, though?
Yeah, I mean,
like if you were on the team, really would you say, okay, you know what, Cyclone Spin? I know how good you are. I want you to go Sobek.
I mean, he gave the old clash and slash, man. He can't be stopped.
Whew. Well, you can see it. He gets himself in a tight spot there, but able to pluck his way out of this one. And now he comes right back in, lurking in the waters, slowing everyone down and just looking to zone out everyone there. And he's just right there. You can just tell he's reacting to call-outs.
And he hugs the edge of the circle of protection there. So he makes sure he doesn't do any damage to it to get it bigger. Make sure that he doesn't take any damage from it as well. I mean, Cyclone just played that beautifully.
I feel like it's every time we cast an AFK match, it's just like, my God.
I feel like if we took all the God names out of our cast and just left all of what we said about Cyclone, we could have put that to any other game that he has played in the last year.
Probably. Very, very strong.